It's a bit arguable at the moment, because one example that I came through is in a village, a remote village, when demonetization happened, people had no cash, so the sellers or the, you know, brick and mortar stores or mom and pop stores, they went for the card swipe payments, POS machines basically. And what happened was, after a while, they realized that the transaction charges or the, you know, rental charges of those POS machines are eating into their
margins.
Yeah, margins. So they had to pay around 1400 INR each month for as a rental for those POS machines. So even though it was an example, they tried to, you know, go into the digital economy in that sense or digital payments. They could not do it because there were additional costs. So as one thing that needs to be considered in this scenario is to, you know, somehow reduce the transaction costs associated with digital payments. Because if there are no incentives with digital payments, so one would probably, you know, not be tempted to use the digital payments. Why would someone change all of their, you know, obviously, India is a cash heavy economy. There have been more than 90% transactions are in cash. So why would someone change their mode of transacting to a lower penetrative technology than cash is? So that is something that needs to be considered in case, you know, Philippines decides to do it. And as for how long would India take, we have covered a lot of ground. There have been various initiatives by the governments, by the private sectors, to provide digital payment systems to the public. But we still have a lot of ground to cover, because you know, unlike Philippines, India does not have the level of internet penetration that it should have to, you know, facilitate digital payments too easily. Around 33% of India is connected to internet as of now. And though mobile penetration is around 50%, but there still needs to be a lot of services that needs to be provided, the infrastructure that needs to be built, so that digital payments and digital infrastructure can, you know, go to the grassroots.